Welcome to this month's Nature's Calling. I'm Lucas Bond with the Missouri Department of Conservation. What would it be like to turn back time and look at Missouri's landscape 100 to even 200 years ago? That was the goal for the Missouri Natural Area System in 1977. It set out to protect the best examples of the state's original landscapes, habitats, plants, and animals. Having the Natural Area System in place is like having a picture of what Missouri's landscape once was. Today, there are over 190 natural areas in the state. Some are located at conservation areas, such as Hughes Mountain, Millstream Gardens, Amadon, Pickle Springs, and many more. Natural areas are living museums of our natural history, our state's crown jewels, so to speak. Here in Missouri, they include caves, rich canyons, glades, and prairies. Others contain rare or endangered species or unique features that have always been uncommon, such as large springs, natural bridges, and sinkhole ponds. Most natural areas in the state are open to the public. All natural features are protected and only allow foot traffic within the areas. Some are scenic and accessible, while others are remote and must be located with a GPS or map and compass. The Missouri Natural Area System has made a great start towards preserving the natural features of our state, but much work remains to be done. Many natural communities in the state are still not represented.
So some natural areas represent really unique community types, such as sand prairies or fen wetlands, and we're still working on identifying these sites as well as trying to work with private landowners to help conserve these unique features of our state.
The Natural Area System ensures a future for Missouri's marshes, prairies, forests, glades, streams, and a host of other natural communities and landscapes they belong to. It also guarantees that kids of the future will get to experience what Missouri once was. Here I'm standing at one of the most scenic sites in the state, Millstream Gardens Conservation Area near Fredericktown. People travel from all over the state to see these spectacular granite formations and how they play havoc with the flow of the St. Francis River.
The St. Francis River that flows through this area supports a number of unique fish species and a crayfish species, the St. Francis River crayfish, that is only found in this drainage basin and nowhere else in the world.
The shut-ins are the most popular attraction here, especially in the springtime when water levels are high and whitewater kayakers and canoers from throughout the Midwest come here to take part in the annual whitewater race. Paddlers attempting to float the shut-in should be prepared with adequate experience and whitewater equipment. During low water conditions, the river becomes impassable by all boats, including kayaks. A 2.5-mile hiking trail weaves its way through the area and continues into the adjoining Silver Mines Recreation Area. Here I'm sitting on one of the oldest rocks in the country, on top of Hughes Mountain Natural Area. Here you can find honeycomb-shaped rocks, scorpions, and a view like no other here in Missouri. You can see a 4-county area from the top of Hughes Mountain, which is located about 10 miles southeast of Potosi in Washington County. This is not one of the highest mountains in the St. Francis Mountains area, but because there are no obstructions, you get one of the best views. One feature that makes Hughes Mountain so unique is the angular jointing of the rocks, producing a honeycomb pattern, thus the area's nickname, Devil's Honeycomb. As a natural area, it has been preserved as a relatively undisturbed piece of Missouri. It has changed very little from the time the state was first settled. You can learn more about Missouri natural areas on MDC's website at mdc.mo.gov. Thanks for watching, and remember, nature's calling. Get out and enjoy Missouri's outdoors.